Hello, welcome. It is Monday. The challenge is in full swing. So it is 6:30 p.m. So I got home from work and quickly did some stuff around the house while I listened to some YouTube videos. I was able to do a fair amount at work today because I did have to drive some places. The workplace sun is shining on me for this challenge, and I have to drive somewhere like I think every day this week, so I will be able to listen to audiobooks in the car while I do that. Not like a ton, but maybe like an hour or so. So between my commute time, my lunch time, and the time that I was able to do at work and now after work, I actually am already at 5 hours, so that is very exciting. I am trying to do about 6.5 hours every day during this week because I have to watch my niece on Saturday, and so I'm not sure how much I'm actually going to be able to do on Saturday, and obviously Saturday and Sunday would ordinarily be kind of the makeup lost time days, so I am going to do my best to just not get behind, which so far, knock on wood, is going well. Obviously, it's been one day. If you have seen my video from yesterday, right now, Sunday, I did kind of add two things to, so I'm trying to do the 40 hours in 7 days language challenge, but I also am trying to speak every day and write every day. So currently I have not done either one of those today. I've only done like listening or reading today. So I am going to fold clothes before I go to bed, and then tomorrow I'm going to tackle the dishes. I was going to do that today, but I just don't have it in me. The dishes are my absolute nemesis. So today I listened to some podcasts and I listened to this YA audiobook, probably more like middle grade, to be honest. It was so bad. And so I think I'm actually going to write and speak about that in Spanish. And I am going to record myself speaking this week and try to make a vlog out of that as well, or like a speaking update, you know, speaking challenge, whatever you want to call it. So I am going to get to that now. Okay, so I decided to do something different and try using ChatGPT to correct my writing. So I wrote this paragraph. This was the original version. Google Docs does suggest some things, which is really helpful. It's helpful in English also. But then I had them check it, and it was most of the changes were fairly minor, but they were helpful. But it was funny, they did get something wrong. So like not about Spanish as far as I know, but about the world. So I said that, you know, that's correct, or that's incorrect, and they were like, you're correct that the Higgs boson particle is directly related to the mass of particles, therefore the sentence is incorrect. So that was just very interesting. I will probably post this somewhere, maybe just on Instagram, I don't know. But yeah, day one, I have done my speaking, I've done my writing, I am almost into my 6.5 hours. It is almost 8 o'clock, so I am probably going to take a shower, then make a smoothie and fold my clothes and watch some TV. What is going on with this lighting? Okay, so anyway, it is 8:20 or something like that on Tuesday evening. I have about 4 hours in so far, so I am behind schedule, like not actually behind schedule, but behind my made up schedule in my head. So I'm definitely not going to get 6.5 hours today, but I should still be able to get plenty. I am just a little bit like down today, not seriously, just a little bit. So I have done my speaking and my writing because I wanted to make sure I got those out of the way as soon as I got home from work, pretty much. Well, first I tested to make sure my stream was going to work tomorrow because I've never gone live before on YouTube, so I wanted to make sure that all, like, functioned. So I do want to read some more of my book, but I think I'm actually going to read this graphic novel. I kind of wanted to have these rereads of graphic novels available as kind of something fun and easy to do, and also just to get more out of them than the first time that I read them, which was when I was very early in my Spanish learning comprehensible input life. And I remember this one in particular being very difficult because it is very like fantasy vocabulary and stuff. So I think I'm going to read this one and then get into my book or books. And yeah. Hello. It is Friday afternoon. So Friday is my shortest workday, so it is like 3 o'clock or something, but I have been off for a while. So I went to Target and got some stuff that I needed, and I have about 3 or 3.5 hours in so far today, I think. The past few days have been a little bit of a whirlwind of things. It's like I have time to do the things that I need to do, but barely. Yesterday, I got in the e-reader that I ordered earlier this week. It wasn't supposed to come for like 10 days or something, and then it just came in like 3 days. So that was very exciting, but that totally derailed my studying. So I have it here. I love it so much. I got a pop socket for it. So I will be probably making a video about this on my book channel. But anyway, so yesterday I set that up, and this is actually an Android device, and so it takes a little bit more setup than like a Kindle or something like that would. So it did take me quite a while, but I did watch YouTube the whole time in Spanish, so I'm on track for time. Like I did six hours yesterday, but I'm not necessarily on track for the speaking and writing, so I need to kind of double dose those. I am halfway through the audiobook that I'm listening to, and it's okay. I like the story, like it's very interesting if you like vampire type stories, but I have some problems with the way that it is written, but I will probably talk about that in my Spanish speaking, because yeah, I'll probably do one talking about the new e-reader and one talking about that. But while it is absolutely gorgeous outside, I want to take advantage of that. So when my partner gets off work, I'm going to see if I can convince him to read in the park. I just talked for like a whole minute and I wasn't recording. Okay, so it is almost 6 o'clock on Sunday. I have to get one more hour in, and about 40 minutes of that has to be speaking. And so I am going to fold my clothes, my laundry, put my clean sheets on and stuff, and just talk the whole time that I'm doing that with a timer on, because yeah, I've already done a lot of like talked about a lot of like assigned topics and stuff. So yeah, I just think I'm going to kind of do a spoken diary or whatever, and I'm not going to record it because like I'm never going to re-listen to that or put it in anything, so it would just be a waste of space. I'll just start a timer, but then after that I just need 20 more minutes of whatever and I will be set. So I am so excited that, you know, I will finish on time, that I won't have to try to stress or cram it in or decide whether or not to try to finish or not, you know. But I am very ready to be done, so let's do it. Hello, so it is time to review the stats for the week. So I did reach 40 hours. I had 40 hours in 1 minute. So I had 4 hours and 47 minutes of listening and reading combined, 28 hours and 48 minutes of just listening, 1 hour and 12 minutes of just reading, 2 hours and 5 minutes of speaking, 1 hour and 22 minutes of studying, and 1 hour and 45 minutes of writing. That is sort of normal for me with my listening percentage. I think it was about 72% just listening. That was definitely a lot more active study, like a lot more production and a lot more study than I would normally have. So I'm very happy with that, especially the 2 hours of speaking. The last day when I was trying to do my 40 minutes of speaking, I was struggling. There's probably a lot of dead air of me trying to think of anything to say in there, but I was making the effort to form things in Spanish the whole time, so, you know, it counts. but anyway, I read one audiobook, a middle grade audiobook. I got about 35% into my Isabel Allende book, Hija de la Fortuna. I got to about 50% through my Carrie Soto book, which I had already started, so that one I was not, you know, starting from scratch. And then I got about 62% through my audiobook Rojo. I wrote 3 book reviews and a couple journal entries. I am very, very happy with this week. I enjoyed it so much. Thank you so much to everyone who participated or commented or showed up in a live or, you know, interacted in any way. It made it so much more fun, and I definitely would like to do something like this again. I love language challenges. I think my favorite thing about them is not actually the challenge, but how much it makes the amount that I normally do increase without feeling like it's a lot of effort. Like, the week after I do something like this, you know, getting like 3.5 hours a day or something like that feels like nothing. Whereas before, that might have felt like quite a bit more, you know, like it just raises my tolerance. It raises my ability to fit things in just so much. And although I certainly will not be having weeks like this normally, I think that this kind of stretches what I'm able to do. And also it makes me appreciate my free time, because I do want to read some books in English this week and moving forward. So anyway, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.